were working in one area and a different area had the biggest earthquake. That's just the way it goes sometimes.
So there's a surprise right there.
There was a surprise, absolutely.
Harold Tobin has studied the causes of great earthquakes in Japan for decades, and the giant magnitude 9 Tōhoku earthquake was not what he was expecting first. He and others had been studying geology that leads to quakes further south in Japan, considered a more certain bet for a large earthquake-generating tsunami. But what happened on March 11th of 2011 was bigger than Japanese scientists were expecting. Consider this giant fishing boat being washed over a tsunami protection wall that wasn't tall enough.
The seismologists thought that the maximum possible earthquake was around a magnitude 8. Of course, what happened was a magnitude 9, which is, you know, 10 times larger in amplitude, 30 times larger in the energy the fault releases.
We have an eerily similar geology here off our own coast, where the ocean floor is pushed under the North American continent. It's when these plates suddenly give way that there's not only shaking, but the shift sends tremendous energy into the ocean, and that generates tsunami waves. Tobin first visited the region 5 months after the quake and recorded these pictures.
When you came here and you started to think about lessons learned from Tōhoku, what did you think about how they would be applied to our own situation?
There are tremendous lessons from Tōhoku for our situation here in the Northwest.
One of those lessons, Tobin wants to see hundreds of seismic monitors wired up on the ocean floor, like Japan has already done, because there may be warnings we can get from the way the plates shift offshore that could tell us when a quake is more likely.
And we're starting to get a much bigger, better picture of that these faults are alive in between earthquakes too. And it's that stuff, those observations, that is going to unlock the key for us to whether we can see something that's a run up to an earthquake or not. Don't have the answer for you today, but that is exactly what we're working on.
Our last big earthquake like this was in January of the year 1700. And one of the reasons we know why that earthquake was so big is because the wave ended up wiping out coastal villages in Japan that became part of Japanese history. In Edmonds, Glenn Farley, King 5 News.